Okay, so week three of actually doing stuff. I finally came up with what I thought I would do, and I thought I would join in on the thrift store makeovers because it's actually something I've been doing pretty much my whole life. So I thought, why not do it on camera? So I've actually had a couple of these sitting around for a little while just waiting for me to have time to do them, so what a better time than now? I thought I'd start off with this little jewelry box I found that is made of solid wood. It's got mirror. The top drawer doesn't come out. It's like filled with this, that old felty stuff that's kind of gross. So I might see if I can pull it out, refinish it, I'll come up with something. And then this drawer removes as well. I have like wiped out inside at least, so there's nothing gunky in there. It's old school hinges in the back. I'll probably have to keep the hardware because I'm not really going to go and find new tiny hardware for this. Anyway, so that's a long enough intro. Let's get doing stuff.
The first thing I wanted to do was to pick some sandpaper. And since I was going to rough this surface up just enough to paint it, I started off with an 80 grit and then I grabbed a 120. That's the orange one there, not knowing exactly which one I would need for this project. But I wanted to be able to like give it a good, you know, just rough coat. So started off by taking the drawer pulls off because it's going to be kind of a pain to sand around them. So went and found a small screwdriver and fought with some stripped screws a little bit, but was able to get them out in the end. And they were kind of, they've been on there a long time, so they were kind of stuck on, but I managed to get them off. And then just sand. Until all the varnish was off. I was debating between staining, so I really like went in with the sandpaper rather than just roughing it up. But you'll see what I ended up doing in the end anyway. So then I took the hinges off the top so that we could sand all the edges, all the sides, and really get a good surface. And then I also didn't want to have gold hinges in my finished project, so I was going to paint the hinges and the drawer pulls as well, because I'm not going to go looking for new hardware for this project. So then I grabbed some sandpaper and I sanded and I sanded and I sanded and I dusted. I like to use a paintbrush to dust things off. And then before I started really sanding the whole base, I wanted to get that felt stuff out that's in all those like jewelry boxes that are like, this is an old one. It's probably from the 80s or 90s. So it's all yellowed, probably with nicotine. It definitely had a smell when I started ripping it apart. And so I had to go get some needle nose pliers and just like pry it out. I was trying to figure out like the best way to do it. And it was not easy. That stuff's really in there. But once I got it kind of loosened, it got a lot easier to get it out once I figured out how everything was in there. And this is just like it's like particle board or like a compressed paper board or something with like felt foam stuff over. I don't even know what this stuff is. So just ripping it out, cardboard backing attached and everything. And then the side ones were like really on there. So I had to go get my trusty sharp thing and kind of scrape it off, give myself something to grab because I didn't want to damage the box with needle nose pliers. And once I could grip them with the pliers, everything came off super easy. And then you guessed it, I sanded some more. And finally I had a good finished surface. I got out my electric vacuum cleaner and just got all the dust vacuumed up, and then started taking the foam fabric insert thing out of the drawer as well and doing the same process over again just to get that out. It was glued on a little tighter in the drawer. So you'll see how I handled that. So I couldn't find my new container of craft paint. No idea where I left it. I had, you know, Apple Barrel 50 cent black paint that's brand new and I couldn't find it. So I used this old one and I think this is from like 2007. And so it's like a mixture of thick, chunky and watery. So it was kind of almost doing like a stain thing, which is not really what I wanted, but a cool look regardless. So I just gave everything a coat and then looked again for my new black one and I couldn't find it. So I had to get out the Liquitex Basics, and I'm really upset that I had to use my Liquitex paint for this because it's not what I wanted to use, but I have no idea where I put my paint, and that's a common thing that I have a problem with, but we won't talk about that right now. So yeah, just gave everything a solid coat of black paint, getting everything nice and matte and flat to start off, because I was still trying to figure out what I wanted to do with this, but black is a fairly decent neutral color in my mind anyway. So I was trying to get a better view. I was like, I thought I cut this out. So this is me trying to get a better view of the box there, because I noticed in the lens it was hard to see because it was so flat black. So I didn't paint the bottom because I'm gonna glue felt onto the bottom to make it slide smoother, so I just didn't worry. I painted it over the edges a little bit so that the felt would be there, and then painting the rest of the drawer with the Liquitex again, and you can see in the background I've painted the hinges as well. So everything's got a good coat of paint. I'm gonna go ahead and varnish it just with some matte Mod Podge, give everything a good coat so that I can then touch it up again, because when you paint with acrylic paint on to wood, it tends to come off. So then I'm going to work on the drawer pulls. So I've got a good stiff brush, and I've got some bronze folk art paint, and I've got my matte black painted drawer pulls. So I'm going to do like a dry brushing on them with the bronze paint. So I'm just going to tap a little bit onto the brush, dust it on, and then I'm going to get a paper towel and wipe off a lot of the wet paint so that I don't have a solid coat, but it gets into like the high, it didn't get as much into like the, I was hoping that it would get onto the highlight parts and not get into the deep parts, but because I didn't get enough of the paint off of the brush before I started, it actually got into the grooves, so it did almost more like an antiquing instead of like a the opposite effect that I was going for. So just hitting both those drawer pulls in the same way, and that's what they're gonna look like in the long run. So you can kind of see here, it gives them almost like a weathered, brassy bronze look, which I really liked. I think worked really well with what I ended up going with in the end. So that's what they look like up close. They're very, very tiny. I have small hands, very tiny. Okay, so now it's time to decorate the box. So I went back and forth on what I wanted to do. So I grabbed that lace, and what I tried to do originally was paint over the top of the lace to give that like lace effect. Did not work with the lace that I had. So then I decided with the bronze again, I would go ahead and maybe try dry brushing onto the box. But what it did was it just went into all the grooves from my sanding, because once I got the varnish off, this wood was really, really soft. And so I should have probably gone with a 120 grit. So it just made it look all, it didn't give it the look I wanted. So I scrubbed off as much of that as I could again. And then I went ahead and hit it back with the black, because I gave up. So I repainted the side black again, so that wasn't going to work. So I coated back over again, and then I tried messing with the lace again, and I thought maybe I'll glue the lace down. I did that with another box and I kind of liked it, so I was like, maybe if I paint the lace itself bronze and then attach it to the box, and it'll give a texture, because I just wanted this box to have some texture. So I didn't like the blue lace, so I went ahead and got a different lace that I have. And I cut a square roughly the size that I wanted, and then I cut the pattern of the lace that I wanted out of it. And what I tried to do again was like, maybe with this lace, I'll be able to get a better pattern. And the answer was no. You'll see in a second. It was a no. It was a big, big, big no. And I thought maybe instead of the brassy bronze, we'll go with this purple shimmer that I bought that I haven't used. And it's a cool color. And it gave it a cool, like, Tim Burton-y kind of color palette. But, oh boy, it did not look good. It just looked like I let a little kid paint it. So, again, I tried, okay, well, what if I paint the lace and then glue the lace on? And so I spent a good, like, 10 minutes painting this lace and decided I didn't like it. So I tried, okay, what if I glue this black lace on for that texture? And I kind of liked that, but I also didn't. So I moved on again. And I decided to, I came up with this idea of making it look like a weathered aged coffin. I wanted to go with more of vampire goth inspired rather than Tim Burton emo goth inspired. So I mixed up this Tuscan red apple barrel paint with some of my Liquitex black. And I'm sorry, my camera keeps like randomly zooming in and I didn't realize that it was so zoomed in. So I painted some red splotches on the box, on the lid as well. So that was me checking the lid was dry. And then I just kind of painted some random red areas. And right now it looks really, really ridiculous. But I will explain the purpose. And I'm really excited that this worked. I don't normally like this effect, but I think it looked really cool here. So then I did it all over in areas where I thought it wouldn't be distracting. And I let it dry overnight. And then I grabbed some school glue, and put it over the areas where I had painted. And I'll zoom out here in a second because, oh my God, Tiff, that's so close. Pay attention to where your camera's at. So I found a super cool like chalk painting brush at the dollar store. And so I grabbed that. It's a great glue brush. There we go. Now you can see. So I've just like smothered glue on here. And I'm just kind of coating it over the red and letting it be different textures, different thicknesses and thinnesses. And I'm not really worrying about, I don't want to get a smooth coat on it. I just want to have it over the top of the red and a little bit over the black because I wanted it to kind of blend a bit, but not too much. And then going back in areas where I thought it was maybe a little too thin and adding a little more glue so that I can thicken it up a little bit. And then putting that down. And then I'm going to get, as soon as that's done, come on, Tiff, finish up, hurry up, come on. So while the glue is still wet, but not, it needs to be a little bit tacky. So I kind of let it dry a little bit, got some more Liquitex black and a soft paintbrush, and I painted over the top of it with the black. So I just went over the areas where there was the glue and a little bit, actually, that was my goal, but I ended up going over the whole thing, but I went thicker over the areas with the glue. And the key here is to not work your paint too much. So what's going to happen is as the glue dries, the glue is going to like shrink and it's going to pull the paint with it. And it's going to create this kind of crackle effect. They do it like a lot of furniture makeover people. I want to say restorers, but they're not really restoring it. But they'll do this on older pieces for that shabby chic look or weathered look. And so what this is going to do is it's actually going to pull the black away so that you're going to see the red underneath. And because I didn't put the glue on the black areas, the black paint's just going to cover over the black. And if there is a little bit of glue, it's just going to crack into the black. So you're going to get a texture, but not like a color effect. And I went with this really dark red because I didn't want it to be too costumey. I mean, it looks like a prop piece, but I feel like it's subtle enough that it's like not going to be, oh my God, why? So then I did that for the lid as well and all the other places where I put in the red. And so you can see the lid here has a whole lot of glue on it. And here's her finished. So I didn't record doing a second coat of Mod Podge for the varnish again, putting everything back together. I didn't have time. But then my favorite is the inside. I coated with a black velvet. So the inside of that old thing, the old top, is now just a solid open part. And then the drawer as well is going to open into with a velvet lining. It's not perfect, but I'm pretty happy with it. So thanks for watching.